What happened here? Any kind of the lights. The first nature of the light is any kind of the light when passes from the one medium to another medium. Here there is an air present. Outside of this prism, there is an air present. And this is the another medium. We call as a medium. I told when I have started the light chapter, I told that there is a property in which I told that light travels in a medium. Light travels in a medium. Here, what is the medium? There is an air medium which we cannot see. But here, the another medium, that is a glass medium, and that glass is basically called as a prism. This glass is basically, what is this? This is a prism. Now, once any kind of light, when passes from this medium, light is coming from any source. Light is coming from any source. When this light passes, what is their medium present? Here, medium is an air present. Here, air is a medium present. When the light travels in this medium and strike on the second medium, and on which object this light strike, that is glass. Since it is a transparent, that's why we call as a glass medium. When light travels from one medium to another medium, there is a property. There is a light's another property. When light travels from one medium to another medium, what happened here? You draw a normal line on this striking point. On this striking point, draw a normal line. What happened when light comes from one medium and gets into second medium? Either it bends towards the normal line or away from the normal line. So when the light came from air to glass medium, it signifies that light bends towards the normal point. Light slightly bends towards the normal point. So the path is changed of this light. And it slightly changed from its position. You can see, observe inside. There is no ray inside this, but we can just observing it that there is a light which slightly changed their path. What is the path? Path of this light is indirectly moved from here to here. Its actual path, this light actual path should be this, but since it gets changed their medium, that's why the light rays this not move on this path. It just slightly changed to their path and move to the next phase. What happens here? You again directly draw a normal point on this line, on this point. And what happened? Now this inside this light again travel from glass medium to air medium. Here is a glass present. When light gets out from this glass, then we call light travels glass medium to air medium. Here is air present. Glass medium to air medium. And as I already told that when the light gets from one medium to another medium, since the medium is here, what is the medium? Here medium is glass, and where the light is light goes to enter into the air medium. That's why the second property, in which when the lights came from that medium is a
denser medium.
Since the density of this glass is high as compared to the air, that's why when the medium change from one part to another part, the light goes denser medium to the flexible medium, that is air. And in this medium, the light away from the normal point, so it goes like this. And also the change of also this light change their path also. So in this way, any kind of the system which is transparent, in this transparent medium, when light gets inside, the medium change. Once the medium change, there is a air. Air is a flexible medium because the atom of air is a far away. That's why the light not gets directly affected by these atoms. Somewhere it is affected, but directly not affected. Once it gets inside this prism, it changes their path because from flexible medium to denser medium, it changes their path. And where it changes, it bends towards the normal point. This light bends towards inside this glass. The light bends towards the normal. And again, when this light passes to the next surface of this prism, it again the light gets outside from this medium. That means the light passes from the denser medium to flexible medium. What happened here? Here the light which comes from the denser medium is passed away from the normal point. This is the normal point, and this light is coming from the denser medium, so it is away from this normal line. In this way, reflection takes place. This kind of the light, as already told in the plane mirror, this kind of the light is basically known as incident light, incident light. And this kind of the rays which came from the second surface, that is called the reflection, or we call as a reflection ray. We call as a reflection ray. In case of plane mirror, where there is a medium not changed, but in case of plane mirror, there is a medium not changed. But in case of prism, the medium changed. Medium change means the air, first air, the light passes from air medium, gets inside the glass medium. Again, from glass medium to air medium, lights come out. So here the light change their medium. That's why this kind of the light which came out from the second surface, that is called the reflection. Got it? If you have got it, then please type. Your impression so that I can understand you are getting or not. If you are not getting, then allow me to ask a question so that I will ask. Raise your hand so that I will understand that there is a problems are coming. I'm just going to pause my. Now, what happened here? Put a screen here where the reflection lights are coming. Okay, this is a screen. Now, once you put a screen behind this prism where the reflection lights are coming. What happened here? We observe that there are the number of the blinking lights which are blink on this screen. When we put a screen behind this mirror where the reflection of lights are striking, we suppose that there is a, we observe that there is a number of lights are blinking on this screen. Number of lights are blinking on this screen at a different place. Number of lights are blinking on this screen Number of lights are blinking on this screen at different places. Number of light 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are the 7 lights are blinking on this screen at a different place. At a different place. When this kind of the conditions are created, we suppose that the lights which is coming from any source, that is white color light. The lights which coming from the source is a white color light. When this white color light observe on this screen, we observe that there these lights are divided into different color light. This white color divided into different color light. This kind of the situation is called dispersion of light. What we call is dispersion of light. Dispersion of light. The division of white color light into seven color. That property of light is called the dispersion of light. Remember it. When this light, one color light, white color light, disperse at a different place, disperse, divided into at a different place. That's why this color of light is known as a dispersion of light. What we call dispersion of light. Fine. This is called dispersion of light. And this dispersion of light is basically called as a bipure. B-I-B-Y-O-U-R. This color light name as bipure, B-I-B-Y-O-U-R. Bipure. B-I-B-G-Y-O-R. Bipure. It is called bipure. This is the dispersion of light. Okay, fine. Now I am going to ask you again any doubts.